Right now, the Lake County Sheriff's Office says it's beginning the process of firing one of its deputies. Matthew Donnelly is accused of sexual assault while on duty. He bonded out of jail last night. WESH News' Ricky Klaus went to his home this morning and has the latest.
Deputy Matthew Donnelly worked for the Lake County Sheriff's Office for 13 years, and during that period, he only had one disciplinary issue.
And that was for his refusing to respond to an animal complaint.
Sheriff spokesman John Harrell says his colleagues are surprised.
Everyone's surprised. We are disheartened. Obviously, it's discouraging. You know, it's really hard to see a law enforcement officer get arrested for breaking the law that they themselves are sworn to uphold, but it's especially hard when it's one of your own.
Early on New Year's Day, a man flagged Donnelly, who was on patrol. He says his girlfriend passed out, needed help. She admitted she drank a lot earlier at an Orlando bar. The affidavit says when she came to, the woman realized Donnelly was standing by her car door. She says he told her, "You're sexy, and I have a wife." The affidavit says he placed her boyfriend in the back seat of his patrol car. The document says the dash cam was turned off for 22 minutes.
Obviously, they had both been drinking, so she assumed that he was under arrest for DUI.
The affidavit says he groped her, and a sex assault exam later confirmed she had been injured.
As he was touching her, he was telling her that he would not take her boyfriend to jail. He would let him go if she didn't tell anyone.
Detectives swabbed Donnelly's patrol car and sent the samples to a state lab. The results came back yesterday.
The victim's DNA was found on Donnelly's steering wheel, his flashlight, and the gear shifter knob.
Deputies arrested Donnelly last night. He bonded out soon after. Harrell says the evidence against Donnelly is so strong that even if he's found innocent in court, he likely won't work in law enforcement again. Reporting in Lake County, Ricky Klaus, WESH 2 News.